I look forward to when these pots are dried and get them fired and glazed. We can bring them back in and have a couple more drawings.
Anything else that you'd like to share with us, Mark? I know there's so much that we could learn, and we've really just scratched the surface of the illustrations. And now this pottery here, the little gray pots, what is this called?
This is a low-fire earthenware, is what the terminology would be called.
And at this stage in the process, what is it called?
Oh, this stage in the process, this is called greenware. It's still green. It's very fragile. It's not hard enough. It's not been fired, so they just call it greenware.
You know, do you ever feel like in your life that you're at a point where you're just kind of on the shelf waiting? You don't understand what's going on? Maybe you're at this point here where it's just the pot has been formed and it's waiting to be fired. It's waiting to have the glaze applied. It's waiting for that next step. And sometimes we think waiting is useless. We think rest is not part of the process when in fact it is. What would happen if you took a pot like you just made there and just put it in the fire?
It wouldn't survive. It would just fall apart.
Do you think God knows when we're at that point that we can survive through a trial? When we're at that point where instead of the trial destroying us, it makes us stronger. Wherever you are on the road of life, you are in the process of becoming the unique person God wants you to be. All of us are on the way to becoming more, and none of us have arrived yet. Joshua chapter 1 and verse 9 says, "Have not I commanded thee? Be strong and of a good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee whithersoever thou goest." When the potter is shaping the vessel, whatever shape he gives it on the outside depends on how open he can make it on the inside. And that's like us as well. Whatever shape he gives us on the outside depends on how open he can make us on the inside. And when we think about shape, it's not so much physical form, but the purpose for which God can use us. How open are we on the inside? How open is our heart to God? Have we released the bitterness, the hurt, the regrets? Have we allowed God to come into our innermost souls and heal the hurt that is there? Deuteronomy chapter 32 and verse 18 says, "Of the rock that begat thee, thou art unmindful. Thou hast forgotten that God formed thee." Job realized his own position. He said, "Behold, I am according to thy wish in God's stead. I also am formed out of the clay." And in Isaiah 43 and verse 1, it says, "But now thus saith the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by thy name, and thou art mine." Just as that little vessel became out of center, it became marred, it became misshapen. And as Mark skillfully pulled it back into the center and created the pot that you see there, we may make mistakes. We may make choices that take us out of the center of God's will. But he comes to us and says, "Fear not, I have redeemed thee. If you come to me, I have the power to remake you into what I want you to be." And in verse 7, Isaiah chapter 43 and verse 7 says, even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I have made him. As we mentioned earlier about what if we were one of the little pots there, looking around at the other vessels and wondering why we didn't have a handle or why we didn't have a lid. Romans chapter 9 and verse 20 says, "Nay, but O man, who art thou that repliest against God? Shall the thing formed say to him that formed it, why hast thou made me thus? Why have you made me this way?" I'd like to share a song with us now. It's entitled "The Master Potter." And it asks the question, "Master Potter, why do you labor all day, giving such effort to rough, worthless pieces of clay? Why such feeling in your hands? Why such care in every touch? Why all the struggle? Your creation is nothing but dust." And the answer comes, "I'm molding a masterpiece, a work of great beauty. I'm molding a masterpiece, my labor's not done. A trophy, a treasure, of worth beyond measure. I'm molding a masterpiece of love." Master Potter, why do you labor all day, giving such effort to rough, worthless pieces of clay? Why such feeling in your hands? Why such care in every touch? Why all the struggle? Your creation is nothing but dust. Loving Jesus, why are the children all here gathered around you and eagerly clinging so near? Urgent matters clamor loudly, and the children interfere. Why do you hold them and so tenderly dry every tear? I'm molding a masterpiece, a work of great beauty. I'm molding a masterpiece, my labor's not done. A trophy, a treasure, of worth beyond measure. I'm molding a masterpiece of love. Heavenly Father, sometimes I question your way. Why do you ask me to mold simple pieces of clay? Give me eyes to see the future, though it's hidden from my view. Give me compassion as I'm molding a treasure for you. I'm molding a masterpiece, a work of great beauty. I'm molding a masterpiece, my labor's not done.
a trophy, a treasure of worth beyond measure. I'm molding a masterpiece of love.
As we close this evening, I want to thank Mark for coming and sharing with us. I've been blessed, and I hope that you have as well. And tonight, I'd like to just offer a simple appeal. That if you've felt the Holy Spirit speaking to your heart, I'd like to just invite you to just slip out from your seat and just join me at the front. I'm going to ask Pastor Danny to come and just have a prayer of dedication for each one of us. As we say, Lord, I sense your Spirit working in my life. And I realize sometimes I might not be as pliable. I might have defects in my life. I might be stiff. I might need more kneading. I might need more working. But Lord, as you work in my life, I want to tonight just surrender to your working, because I want to be all that you want me to be. And if that is your heart's desire tonight, I would just invite you to just come to the front, and we'll just make a circle here and just ask the Lord to continue his working in our lives. We may not be able to see just what it is that the Lord wants us to be, or just what our purpose is, but we just want to be all that God would have us to be. Pastor Danny, if you would just pray for us.
Father in heaven, we stand before you at this moment, under the wings and shadows of your love for us. We stand here, Father, as your human family created, Lord, to be given honor and praise unto you. We stand here, Father, needing your guidance and your love. Father, thank you that as many as we are, each one an individual, that you placed us on your potter's wheel, on your board. You chartered a destiny for each of us. There was a plan, Father, that you put forth. We may have deviated from that plan. If we look at our footsteps, we see where they went from left to right. But Father, there was a times when we heard your voice, such as this, when you were calling to us by your Spirit, saying, this is the way, walk you in. And Father, tonight we come just to humble ourselves before you and ask you to help us hear your voice and feel your hands of guidance and your tugging the word of hearts to continue to see. May we make a decision tonight to follow you in all the ways that you have led us to this series of meetings. The wonderful things you shared with us. Father, we heard your voice. We felt your Spirit. And Father, we realized your love and care for us. And tonight we surrender our lives to you. And we pray that you would help us to continue honoring our destiny. Lord, now may we have the power of your Spirit in the realm of us. Your Son Jesus, to help us walk.
Amen. Amen. May God bless you, each one. Thank you so much for coming. We'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow morning if you're able to join us at 11 o'clock, and tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock for our concert. So may you all go forth and be worthy vessels in God's service.